Well, our Fox Undercover reports have prompted calls from Compton police, gang members themselves, family and welfare officials. Some of them venting on us, overlooking what this story has really been all about. The failure of society to deal with little boys joining street gangs. So here is more of Chucky Midget and Tortilla Flats.
Well, you have to be good.
12-year-old Midget, his mother with him, is headed to court. He broke his probation, sawing off an electronic ankle bracelet that kept him under house arrest. His mother, who requests her face not be on camera, will leave the courthouse alone. The judge sends Midget to jail.
I feel terrible. I just have to go home and pray that everything comes out all right. Maybe my son is safer now in there than out here in the street. Maybe that's a better place for him right now.
Here in Tortilla Flats the next day, Saturday night gang life goes on without Midget.
I'm a troll of Front Compton, and I'm here to teach the Chicano version of the Compton streets.
Chucky, living with the gang members for about 7 weeks, now has been initiated or jumped in by the gang. We ask Little Woody about Midget going to jail.
I feel sad, man, but that's my brother. He's picking up dust inside.
But here in the flats, jail is taken in stride, even for a 12-year-old.
He does an ROP, runs his own program. You know what I'm saying? He knows what's up. If you do the crime, you do the time. He's down for the flats.
Chucky tells us he will never leave the flats. This is his new home. He will not tell us where his real family is. But 3 days later, our investigation takes us to this tree-lined neighborhood in Southgate. Here, children play in the front yard, and across the street we find Chucky's real home.
I love you and I want you to come home.
His mother, Norma Garcia, says Chucky, whose real name is Angel, just didn't come home one day.
He just left because he wanted to. I mean, nobody told him to go or nothing. I wasn't mad at him.
5 days went by before she filed a missing person report with the Southgate police. She says she was confused.
You know, little baby growing up and wants to live his own life, I guess.
Chucky's mother and father lived together 7 years and separated 4 years ago. Here, where Chucky last went to school in Southgate, administrators would not go on camera but say Chucky had some behavior problems.
I think they accused him of hitting a little boy or something like that, and then after that he just, like I said, he went with his friends and left and never didn't come back.
Chucky tells us, troubled by the problems at school, he just started walking down the railroad tracks and ended up in Compton, where he discovered Tortilla Flats.
I mean, I'm glad to have him around, you know? The big one was had me when I was little, you know?
Crook, a gang member who grew up on the streets, says Chucky found a home here.
This is the only place that he sees love, you know what I mean? This is the only place that he sees people watching out for him and, you know, taking care of him and, you know, giving him stuff and pay attention to him.
Hey!
Chucky's mother says family members several times came here to the flats looking for Chucky, but couldn't find him.
He's not a bad little boy.
Angela, who calls herself Chucky's aunt, but in fact is just a family friend, worries. She wants her face concealed.
If he stays in the street, he's just going to end up getting killed. I know he is. I have dreams about him, you know?
10 days after talking to his mother, we catch up with Chucky again.
They probably have my whole family looking for me. Probably. They won't find me.
You avoid him, huh?
Huh? Yeah. I'll run.
We read him a letter from another aunt who lives in Texas with his grandparents. It was given to us by Chucky's mother.
We are still waiting to hear from you. I pray to God that you are okay. We all love you and want you to come live over here.
Afterward, Chucky agrees to call Texas and makes arrangements for his granddad to pick him up.
Yep. In a couple of weeks, though. Okay.
In the meantime, Chucky refuses to let us take him back to Southgate. And after 18 days in jail, Midget arrives back in the flats. He says it was boring in jail.
Try my best, but I know I'll be back there someday. I'll try my best to be good.
4 days after Midget's return, dozens show up for a party here at the flats. The hangout driveway is filled with gang signs and dancing feet. Several show off their firepower. Midget gets a welcome home from jail. And Chucky, with a fresh gang haircut and dressed out in full cholo regalia, smiles above the crowd.
There's cars all the way up the street, huh?
Then police. And police cars flood the street. The party is over.
This is an unlawful assembly. I'm declaring it. Get in your car and leave.
We leave, and that is the last we see of Chucky, Midget, and Tortilla Flats.
You got about 2 minutes.
Last night, we learned Little Midget was picked up in a Compton police raid and sent to juvenile hall on a probation violation, his second within a month. We also learned some of Chucky's family found him in Tortilla Flats Monday night and took him back to his mother in Southgate. Clearly, this does not end this story, and it is not just about two little boys, but thousands of kids in Southern California swept into gang life at an early age.